यदा यदा हि धर्मस्य
ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान गण प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि। ओम प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। माय बेस्ट विशेस एंड परिपूर्ण आशीर्वादम। मे द ऑल माइटी श्री वेंकटेश्वर बिस्टो ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी वेल्थ एंड हेल्थ एंड एंटायर हैप्पीनेस टू यू एंड योर फैमिली मेंबर्स। लेट अस बिगिन भगवद्गीता चैप्टर नंबर 3 वर्स नंबर 28। श्री भगवान उवाच तत्ववित्तु महाबाहो गुणकर्म विभागयोः गुणा गुणेषु वर्तन्ते इति मत्वा न सज्जते। लॉर्ड कृष्णा इज एक्सप्लेनिंग द कर्म हाउ इट डिफर्स फ्रॉम ज्ञानी एंड अज्ञानी। द कर्म ऑफ अज्ञानी It's completely different from the karma of Ajnani. How Ajnani adapts himself with karma was explained in the last verse. So when he explained, he used the word prakritihi. This prakrite kriyamanani karmani. That word prakriti has not been explained by Lord Krishna. The same word also used by Lord Krishna in the fifth shloka of the same chapter. There he used nahi kaschit kshanam api jata tishthatya karma krut karyate hyavashah karma sarva prakriti jair gunaihi sarvaha prakritihi jaihi gunaihi. By the characteristic gunas which are originated from the prakriti alone does all the karma, but Atma remains as Akarma Akarta. It was the explanation there. Here also he does the same. Prakritih kriyamanani gunaih karmani sarvashaha. Same meaning. So Prakriti does everything. But Ajnana thinks that I am the doer. I am doing everything. That's a wrong understanding. This Prakriti will be explained later on in 7th chapter. So there he explains as bhumi rapo nalo vayuho khambano buddhirevacha ahankara yati yamme bhinna prakriti rashtadha. The eightfolded prakriti does all the work. He will explain there, but he has not explained here because the subject matter of Bhagavad Gita is three, as I told in the beginning itself, the individual consciousness and the world and God. These three subjects are the main subjects. The first sixth chapter deals about an individual. The second sixth chapter deals about the world. There alone he will explain the name of Prakriti. Prakriti means Maya. Maya means that which is endowed with the three gunas, and all these pancha bhutas are modifications of three gunas. Therefore, guna means there are two meanings. One is about the characteristic of an object. So those characteristic also can be called gunas, or the five elemental aspects itself can be also called guna. Now the body is nothing but made up of three gunas, sattva, rajas, tamas. Every object in the world is made up of three gunas. We can also say that they are made up of prakriti. Also we can say that they are which is the originate of three gunas. Therefore, this tattva vitta, Tattvabhit means the knower of the truth is very careful. He won't make himself as the center. So for this, I will give an example. Because when you read only philosophy, tattva, your mind will become dry. So that the thousands of years ago, we were thinking, the human being were living with the conclusion, the every planets around the earth, they revolve only the earth. Earth is the center point of the universe. It was the thinking before Nicholas Copernic. Then after him, he only found that Earth is not the center point. The sun becomes center point. Before that, we were thinking sun was revolving the earth. We were the center. Then after the understanding about the earth, earth alone revolves. It was amazing, shocked truth. But not only, you know, you need not to go that far. You can just, you know, when you sit in a train. So there are two trains nearby, adjacent, okay. So the train which, you know, suddenly you feel, the train in which you are sitting, you suddenly feel the train has started moving. So you have a friend, that friend had gone somewhere to take something. Suddenly you got a hurry in your mind. Within fraction of 3 or 4 seconds, you realized your train is not moving. The nearby train is moving. So that is the mind. Mind cheats. Mind cheats means mind has limited capacity. So the karma is beyond our understanding. Therefore, this Ajnani, not knowing the factor, he thinks, I am the author of karma. I am the doer of karma. It means he thinks the body is me. Therefore, whatever the action takes place in the body, I am the doer. After his departure also, the karma will continue in the body. Isn't it? So when person dies, after his death also, karma has, it penetrates in different way. Now blood circulates and air circulates. After that, the outside panchabhutas will penetrate. There will be, you know, decompose all those kind of actions. So different kinds of action will take place. So that we have to be very careful with the karma, whether we are author or not. But this tattva jnani, tattvavit, he knows very well. He knows with the understanding, I am nothing but akarta. He could identify with real I. He won't identify himself with ahankara, which is the small I. Small I is conjuncted with body, mind, sense. Therefore, he is protected. That's what here he says. Tattva vittu mahabaho guna karma vibhaga yoho. One more secret you should remember, which I told. This body is because of our karma pala. This universe which helps you to enjoy is because of your karma pala. Now, in order to enjoy your karma pala, the world is given, the incident, accidents are fixed. In that, your ahankara, which is also given, supplied one, it takes the main role to bring experiences. Okay? Now, this tattvavitu, he will start witnessing his own ahankara. Ahankara does the job. I am not the author. But not with irresponsible way. He will be very responsible person. He will be careful with his own ahankara. He will lead his ahankara towards dharma alone. It's not that I didn't do after killing a person. I didn't do that because I am the akarta. Ahankara only the doer. He won't say that. He will make his ahankara. Therefore, you could see that all sadhus, sannyasis and great people, karma yogis, after even realizing the Brahman, after the realization also they construct the temple, they will be sitting with puja and they will give the job to their body, mind and sense complex. They will allow them to be endowed with proper dharma karya. That's what jnani. They know guna guneshu vartante. They know that this ear is a guna. Any product in the prakriti, in the srishti, creation is called guna. So ear is conjuncted with the sound. Nose is conjuncted, connected with smell. Tongue is connected with the taste. You cannot separate. When there is a sound, ear will go. Ahankara, if it is kept with a proper puja attitude, it won't get into that. He knows how to manage ahankara, which is the part of srishti prakriti. But he will remain as the sakshi. He will enjoy being the sakshi. At the same time, he will keep all this body, mind and sense complex engaged with dharma karya. That's what the proper meaning here. Yet prakriti is not revealed, unfolded, explained by Krishna. We will keep it as a silent. It's a huge subject. Prakriti means you should talk about 24 varieties of all tattvas, chaturvimshati tattvam. So that we will see later. Okay, again he brings the same word. Don't get confused. Keep it silent. We will go, you know. We are not in a hurry. Prakrtir guna sammodhaha sajjante guna karmasu tana krastna vidho mandan krastna vinna vichalayet. Prakrtir guna sammodhaha guna karmasu sajjante tana akrastna vidaha tan akrastna vidaha mandan krastna vid na vichaldayet. Because these ajnanis are deluded by the prakriti itself due to their karma phala. Therefore, understanding that, don't confuse the ajnani. Don't interact with him. Therefore, my request to all of my students, I always do, don't talk the philosophy or the meaning of the words of Bhagavad Gita wherever you go with the people who are not interested. If they want to study, and allow them also study with you. You can have the discussion as the teaching, as the study, not to debate. Don't go for any debate. This is not the matter for the debate. Debate, it has to be samvada. Samvada means, so it has to be between two learned people, not the people outside. Don't victimize them. When we study, we have to study, we have to enjoy ourselves. We have to do inquiry, not debate with others, because they will get more confused. Therefore, don't do that. My request is that. Usually, I have the request with my students who attend regular classes. Because when you learn systematically, verse by verse, verse by verse, verse by verse, so we create the understanding capacity. That capacity also is increased by the words. So suddenly, if anybody, you know, if you feel good, you know that there is power is called Brahman, there is a power is called Prakriti, they won't understand anything. They will, instead of it, they will start criticizing your understanding capacity. Don't do it. We need not to get it done that. He says, ajnanis are deluded by his own mind and body sense complex. Not only that, he is deluded by outside gunas, outside karma, because his delusion, because of his own karma phala, due to the creation. The creation is given because of his karma phala. That is the understanding. Now you may get, oh my God, you may get a confused state. What will I do? So this much of subject matters are there, I'm not able to get, I'm not able to understand, then Krishna says, don't worry. Give everything to me. You just surrender in me. So he says in three places. In the beginning he said, now he is saying, later on in the 18th chapter also he will say, Mayi sarvani karmani sanyasyadhyatma chetasa nirashir nirmamo bhotva yodhyasya vigatajvaraha. So if you are ajnani or ajnani, it doesn't matter. Just you give all the responsibility, you surrender to me. All the dharmas, you don't worry. You become worry-free. Mayi sarvani karmani sanyasya. You surrender all your karma duties towards me. Adhyatma chetasa. Not with a normal mind. The mind which is endowed with viveka. Viveka means with knowledge of Shastra. Nirashihi nirmamaha. Then he also says, Vigata jvaraha yudhyasva. You just fight, you just follow your karma without tension. Vigata jvaraha means without tension, restlessness and stress. You just free up your mind. When you free up your mind, you become calm and quiet, peaceful minded. So when you are peaceful minded, Nirashihi or Nirashi, Ashihi means expectations. Expectations means always we expect for the fruit. You just remove it. Nirmamaha bhutva, being less mamatva, that mindness, you just keep doing as karma yoga. He has concluded the action. How can it will be converted as Yajna Bhava, Naishkarmya Siddhi? It is known as Naishkarmya Siddhi. Naishkarmya Siddhi means what? Karma Yoga, which is done with selflessness. So that will bring as a Loka Sangraha. So up to these words, he was explaining what Loka Sangraha is. So every one of us should be endowed with Loka Sangraha, not with mere karma as a slave. Next words, Ye me matamidam nityam anutirthanti manavaha shraddhavanto nasuyantaha muchyante tepi karma bhihi. This is the conclusion, this is the teaching of mine. Okay? The people who are endowed with Shraddha, who believe this, who is following with this, all the techniques, with interest, with lots of belief, Shraddha, definitely they will get rid of their karma phala. I am sure about it. He is assuring in the verse number 31 of 3rd chapter. Bhagavan himself, he assures you, definitely you will be benefited. Your karma phala, you can get rid of your karma phala. It means what? You can be liberated. It's a simple meaning, but it has got so many things. Shraddhavantaha, because Shraddha manlabhate jnanam. So only Shraddha people, the people who are endowed with Shraddha. Shraddha means more than belief, in which so many bhavanas are involved. Okay, then also people who are not endowed with Shraddha, who doesn't believe, then what will they get? He said in the next words, read it. Yetve tadabhyasu yantaha nanutirthanti mematam sarvajnana vimudhanstan vidhinashtana chetasaha. Their life will be as a normal life. The normal life, normal mundane life means what? They will be victimized again and again by their birth and death circle. They cannot come out of bondage. They will remain with the karma bandha. That's what Krishna has assured. Now he gives one more explanation about jnani. Because jnani, they have their own nature. Every individual, we have our own nature. For example, so when you draw something, the same painting, we will take and give it 50 people. Same painting, the simple painting. You ask them to draw on the board or on the chart. You can see all of them are not similar. Every one of us don't have similar nature, similar tendency. That's what here said. Sadrusham cheshtate svasyaha prakrtir jnanavanapi prakrtim yanti bhutani nigraha kinkarishyati. Even jnanis act according to their nature. What to talk about others? It means he wants to make us understand whether you are a jnani or a jnani, prakriti leads. Everything is nothing but prakriti. But only one thing, if you are endowed with knowledge, if you are realized the truth, you will be not affected by the prakriti. But prakriti will be taking care of, prakriti will be doing its function in your body, mind and sense complex. But you can be protected because you have realized one. That's what the meaning is given. Prakritim bhutani yanti. That is the statement. Prakriti alone does all the drama. Every drama is nothing but because of prakriti. That is the conclusion. Even jnanis, with the knowledge also, their body, mind and sense complex, it will work according to that. Therefore, you could see all the time there are different characteristics in the jnanis. Vasishtha was having different characteristic. Vishwamitra was having different characteristic. Even Valmiki had a different characteristic. Vyasa had a different character. Durvasa was an angry bird. He was having different characters. All these ancient rishis, you could see different characteristic. Ramakrishna was having different characteristic. And Vivekananda was an extrovert. He was having different characteristic. Even the contemporary of Swami Vivekananda, there was one more Swami called Ramadas. He had a different characteristic. Every jnani is different. Ramana Maharishi, so calm and quiet. Buddha was the person who traveled a lot. Adi Shankara, Ramanuja and Madhva, they have their own prakriti. Prakriti means prakriti visheshaha. Their own system, that system is unique. It's not similar. The difference in their physical system, their psychological system, the way they act, the way they teach, the way they lived, everything is different. Because prakriti's job. But all of them were realized about their true nature. There they don't differ. This is like when you ask all the people to sleep, the sleep is one. In the same way, what they realized, the realization about the subject matter called Brahman alone, even Ramanuja, Madhva, Adi Shankara, and all other jnanis who were there in ancient times. So many jnanis. We call it, you know, Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam Narayanam Padma Bhuvam Vacheshtam Shaktincha Tatputra Parasharancha Vyasam Shukam Gauda Padam Mahantam Govinda Yogindra Mathasya Shishyam Shri Shankaracharya Mathasya Padma Padancha Hasta Malakancha Shishyam. So all these gurus, they had uniqueness. So their body, mind, sense complex, they were ruled by prakriti alone, but they were not ruled by the prakriti. That is the matter here. Therefore, the statement, Prakriti bhutani yanti. Yanti means it rules, it is, that alone exists. Whatever the show happens, it's because of Prakriti. Therefore, you have to be very careful with Prakriti. So, Krishna is to say something about Karma Yoga that we will continue from the next session tomorrow. Harihi Om. My best wishes. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.